in Iran once again makes a stand for Christ. Now he could be executed at any time. Good evening, I'm Lee Webb.
And I'm Lori Johnson. Yousef Nadarkhani has refused once again to recant his Christian faith in an Iranian court. Under Iran's justice system, Pastor Yousef faces a possible death penalty. And as John Waghi explains, his friends in the West are fighting an intense battle to get U.S. leaders to pay attention.
Pastor Yousef is married and the father of two boys. Christian rights groups say he's being charged with apostasy, even though Iranian law doesn't define what that is. Jay Sekulow of the American Center for Law and Justice says the pastor's case is in effect a show trial.
He has been a Christian. He's a pastor of an evangelical church. Technically, under the nonsense of Sharia law, and I'm saying it that way on purpose, he did not even violate it. But that doesn't matter. They have no court system there. This is mock justice, and they're going to try to use him as an example.
Pastor Yousef's Christian supporters say his last chance may be an outcry that causes U.S. and other Western leaders to pressure the Iranian government. Little has been heard from the White House and the State Department, but House Speaker John Boehner's office issued a press release that reads in part, "While Iran's government claims to promote tolerance, it continues to imprison many of its people because of their faith. This goes beyond the law to an issue of fundamental respect for human dignity. I urge Iran's leaders to abandon this dark path, spare Yousef Nadarkhani's life, and grant him a full and unconditional release."
And the world community needs to be saying to Iran that they have to knock this off. If we're going to allow someone to be killed because of their faith, in this particular case hanged, because they're a Christian, and they're out there publicly about it, and the world's going to say nothing, that's an indictment against the rest of us.
John Waghi, CBN News.
The American Center for Law and Justice is working to help free Pastor Yousef. Joining us now from our Washington, D.C. bureau is the ACLJ's Jordan Sekulow. Jordan, Pastor Yousef is standing by his faith. He refuses to recant. What happens now?
The trial is over, so he was given under their Sharia law system there his third and final opportunity to recant his Christian faith. We can confirm that he did not. This trial is on complete lockdown, Lee. I mean, they've got the attorney, basically, who we've been working with, and the state prosecutors, local prosecutors, but no family, no friends. And the troubling part about today, after the trial concluded, was that in the past, family members waiting outside the courtroom could see Pastor Yousef briefly be transferred from the court into a police van and taken back to prison. Today, that did not happen. Now, his attorneys have confirmed that he is, at this moment, still alive. But under their legal system, they have a week to issue a written order. It took 5 months, though, last time, so you can see how important that is to them following these procedures. Mm-hmm. And he could be executed before that order was ever released. And there is no notice to his family nor the public before this execution occurs. So this is a critical time.
Jordan, I wanted to ask you, the fact that he was not transported back to prison, do you view that as ominous?
I do. I mean, it's not happened yet during this 4 days now of trial. Though his attorney again confirmed to us before this interview, he is still alive. He pressed that under their system, you don't have to wait for the ruling to be written down. You don't have to wait for the, there's no notice, so you would not know about it, and an execution could occur immediately. And that's the troubling part of this, is that we could find out tomorrow his fate. We could find out 2 weeks from now, which is why everyone has to continue to pray.
Jordan, I wanted to ask you, I went home after interviewing you yesterday, hoping and praying that the mainstream media and their nightly newscast would have some word of this. They did not. Are they not aware of it? More importantly, is the State Department not aware of this case?
Yeah, the State Department does know about this. Ambassador Susan Johnson Cook, who's the Ambassador for Religious Freedom, issued a very short statement condemning Iran. That's happened also by an undersecretary. But higher levels, for instance, the Secretary of State, Hillary Clinton, she should be speaking out on this. She should have already been speaking out on this, but certainly
why
now.
Why isn't she?
I really, Lee, I don't understand what's happened here, why this is not on their radar. Iran is no friend of ours. I'm not sure why condemning them and calling them out on this is such a negative thing for the United States, especially with everyone gathered together at the United Nations. But you talked about the mainstream media. I got it into the Washington Post at my blog there, which then finally started getting it distributed some. But it's been pretty slow, and that's because Iran has basically no American media there live reporting. They've allowed no media in this courtroom, and they hope that we'll talk about it for a couple of days and then forget talking about the story, and we'll find out, you know, weeks or months later, the fate of Pastor Yousef. We're not going to let that happen.
And we are not going to let that happen either. We will continue to shine a spotlight on it. Jordan, keep us updated, if you will, on this case.
I will. Thank you, Lee.